Hey guys, welcome to Intellipaat. So Java has been around for more than two decades, and that might be one of the reasons for why it has become a go-to programming language when it comes to Android development. But ever since Google announced Kotlin as the official programming language for Android development, wannabe Android developers or even the professional Android developers are in a constant dilemma between Java and Kotlin. And the conclusion of this Java versus Kotlin debate has been a long overdue. So keeping that in mind, we have come up with this Java versus Kotlin video. Now before we move ahead, do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you never miss out on our next videos. So let's start this video by looking at the agenda. First of all, we will be getting a proper introduction to both Java and Kotlin. After that, we will discuss all the parameters on the basis of which we will make the comparison between Java and Kotlin. And then we'll have a look into the latest percentage switching from Kotlin to Java and vice versa. After that, we'll also have a look into the job trends of both languages. And then we'll finally conclude this video by deciding which one is better. We'll also have a short quiz at the end, so make sure you put your answers down in the comment section below. And if you're looking for courses on trending technologies, do visit Intellipaat.com. So guys, without any further delays, let's get started.
Let us first understand what exactly is Java. Java is one of the widely used programming languages expressly designed for use in the distributed environment of the internet. It is a high-level programming language which are interpreted by Java Virtual Machine. Java also supports multi-platform and can run on different platforms including Macintosh, Windows, Unix computers and many more. Now let's move forward and discuss about the Kotlin. Kotlin was developed in 2011 by the programmers of a software development company called JetBrains in Russia, and was then augmented by several open source developers. Kotlin gives developers the features they ask for. Kotlin is a general purpose open source statically typed, pragmatic in the sense practical rather than theoretical programming language for the Java virtual machine and Android that combines both the object oriented as well as the functional programming features. Now we will see some of the pros and cons of both the languages. First and foremost, we will get into Java. After that, we will see what Kotlin is. There are many advantages of Java that clearly represent its recognition among the developers community and enterprises, right? Now, we will see one by one what makes us fascinate to learn Java. It's easy to understand and learn. Also, it is easier to execute which run the code in a browser or in a Java virtual machine. It also provides the open source platform and up-to-date information and a feature-rich programming language, and it has the ability to assemble the large projects precisely with the help of modern tools. It helps in a wide community support that keeps the Java up-to-date, and it is also owned by the Oracle Corporation, who is dedicated to making it stronger. Android also depends upon the Java language, and also there is a flexibility for cross-platform app development. It also guarantees automatic and effective memory management, which makes it portable to use on a range of devices from a large network to the lowest PCs. Some of the cons that makes Java not a prominent language for developing, they are: Java is slow. How can you say that Java is slow? Java is comparatively slower. One problem of Java which always annoys a programmer is this drawback of a Java programming language. Java takes more memory space. It consumes more memory space in the sense compared to other native programming languages like C and C++. This problem haven't been overcome by the Java developers also. Language limited latency critical tuning. If you have to spare every second, then Java is not a best choice, and instead use some other language in such a scenario. Java's architecture code is inefficient. Java's ability for producing portable architectural code is desirable. The method used to create this code is inefficient. Last but not the least, it doesn't guarantee backup. No backup in the sense it's mainly for the storage and less efficient for data backup. So, Java loses its value and prestige in such cases. This is also a drawback that affects Java's rating. It seems like Kotlin has become loved by mobile developers. Here is a list of Kotlin's most prominent benefits. It increases the team efficiency. Being rather clear and compact, the language allows increasing the efficiency. More work can be done as it takes less time and fewer lines to write and deploy working code. compiles with the existing Java code. Kotlin is positioned as the 100% Java interoperable programming language. It is consistent with Java and all related tools and frameworks, which makes it possible to switch to Kotlin step by step. It is easily maintainable. It is easily maintainable in the sense Kotlin is supported by a vast majority of IDEs, including Android Studio and other SDK tools. This helps increase developers' productivity as they can continue to work with the toolkit they are used to. Everyone looks for the less bugs, right? Here is our last but not the least advantage, that is Kotlin is less buggy. Kotlin offers a much more clear and compact code base that makes the code in production more stable and consistent. Bugs are detected at the compile time so developers can fix errors before runtime. We have discussed the advantages of Kotlin. Now we are moving forward with its drawbacks. First and foremost is that they have limited learning resources, as it is a small and new community which is originated in 2011. Therefore, there are only a few experienced people to ask and a few tools to use to pick up some tricks. It may become a challenge to switch from Java to Kotlin for your team. Finding Kotlin developers seems difficult than Java developers. Sometimes compilation is slower compared to Java. Now, we will discuss the major differences between both of them. No doubt, Java ranks as one of the most widely used programming languages, but the cons of Java happen to be the reasons behind the creation of more advanced programming language. First and foremost, we will talk about the establishment. Java, having been developed in the year 1991, is relatively a new programming language. At that time, James Gosling from Sun Microsystems and his team began designing the first version of Java aimed at programming home appliances, which are controlled by a wide variety of computer processors. In 1994, he realized that such a language would be ideal for use with web browsers, and Java's connection to the internet began. Java was launched in 23rd January 1996, which was initially developed by James Gosling at Sun Microsystems, which is now a subsidiary of Oracle Corporation, and released in 1995. Before 2017, Android app developers almost exclusively used the Java 6 programming language with a support for later additions. Java 6 was introduced in 2006, 2 years before the release of Android devices. What happened in 2011 is that the company introduced the Kotlin language, but few Android developers started using it. Although Kotlin was production ready, the language wasn't stable. At Google Input Output 2017, Google announced that Android will support Kotlin as the first programming language from now on, which was then launched in 2017. Kotlin is a statically typed modern programming language that runs on the Java virtual machine by compiling Kotlin code into the bytecode. It can also be compiled to JavaScript source code. Now we will see our second factor, that is compilation speed of Java versus Kotlin. Java, as you know, it is a verbose language. You need to write more and lengthy code that usually contains more errors and bugs. It's that simple. Kotlin uses developer-friendly coding structures and norms that are easy to understand and use. In case of longer code compilation, Kotlin is preferred over Java. This seems quite obvious. When you have larger applications or a bunch of files to be executed, Java is somewhat less considered in terms of speed. Now, our third factor is based on lines of code. Coming to the lines of code, compared to Java, Kotlin has less lines of code, which makes it safe, concise with a lean syntax. Kotlin also offers null safety where it avoids the null pointer exception. If we try to assign or return null to a variable or a function respectively, then it won't compile. Now, we will see this along with an example. We will consider the Hello World program in both the languages. First, we will see the Java Hello World program. Here, the class name is declared as Hello World. Inside the main method, we have printed the Hello World statement. Now, we will see the same in the Kotlin language as follows. Here, the package with Hello and the main function prints with the Hello World. Here, you can notice that there is no semicolon here because Kotlin can be written with or without semicolon. When you consider the above examples from the developer's perspective, you will be able to understand why Kotlin is loved by developers around the world. It is concise, effective, and faster compared to Java. Moreover, there will be a less chance of errors and bugs, resulting in the cost and time reduction. Now, our next factor talks about the interoperability. Interoperability is the Kotlin's core purpose. From the beginning, the project's intention has been to use the existing knowledge and expertise to make every library available to the Kotlin programmers. Developers can simply write the modules in Kotlin that work flawlessly within existing Java code. By emitting the bytecode, a Kotlin compiler allows the two languages to work in unison in the same project. One line of functions take one line. Simple structs or the Java beans can also be declared in one line. Real properties generate getters and setters behind the scenes for Java interoperability. And adding the data annotation to the class triggers auto-generation of boilerplate like equals, hash code to string and much more. Coming to the last but not the least factor, that is what it offers in terms of Android. Java is an object-oriented programming language developed by the Sun Microsystem, which is now owned by Oracle. Being such an old language, Java does a whole lot more than just developing the Android apps. So if you know Java, you have a lot more job opportunities. You may not want to develop only the Android apps all the time. Java lets you spread your wings wider. But if it's specifically about Android app development, the Kotlin mobile app development community is continuing to grow. Back in 2017, Google acknowledged Kotlin by making it the second official language of Android app development. Since then, the programming language has seen a monumental rise in demand in both the developer and enterprise community. With Google announcing that Kotlin is now its preferred language for Android app developers, the language is proving to be pragmatic, modern, and intuitive programming language. Kotlin requires approximately 20% less coding compared to Java. Java will remain essential for Android app development. Switching the entire team to Kotlin at a time can be a bit of a shock, so it is important to do this transition slowly, one person at a time. Having said that, Kotlin is a new official language and owing to its modern nature, it will become widely adopted in the future, so learning it and starting development with it right now would be a good idea. Though Java will continue to be a popular language for a long time and isn't likely to be entirely replaced, so take your time and make the switch gently. At the end of the day, it's all about what you feel comfortable with. To be a true Androidian, you will need to have a working language of Java. But if you already do have that, Kotlin is the language of the future, so you might as well spend some time getting better at it. There are basically two things to keep in mind when deciding if Kotlin is the right choice for your mobile product. First, make sure your product team is ready to make the switch. Introducing a new language, rewriting and optimizing your project introduces a learning curve. It's important to make sure your team is ready to adapt to any obstacles in the learning process. It is equally important to acknowledge how the switch will impact your existing architecture. Changing programming languages can cause the deletion, creation and merging of particular artifacts and classes. As a result, your product's architecture can be damaged. It's critical to ensure that your mobile architecture is expandable and can handle the evolution of your product. Realm, which is a mobile database, performed an anonymized assessment of 1 lakh developers using its database and which languages they were using. Determined by the developer selection of SDKs, Realm found that 20% of apps built with Java before are now being built in Kotlin. Based on that data, Realm predicted that Kotlin will overtake Java on Android by December 2018. Realm also says Kotlin's growth is due to its modernity. Kotlin is a much more modern language. Realm chief maker Paul Kopachki said, "It's easier to understand, it's easier to write, it's a little higher in abstraction compared to Java, and it's really been designed with a mobile in hand." Now, we will get into the job trends of what Kotlin and Java offers. Popularity Index focuses on another set of data to measure the language popularity. According to this index, Java remains the royalty of languages, even though there is a slight decrease in the overall trend to learn the language, comparing to the last AO's results. According to the Gartner, Trends ranking Kotlin is nowhere to be seen. While the popularity of the programming language index shows Kotlin as one of the fastest growing languages, there is a clear discrepancy between what employers require versus what developers want to learn when it comes to the growing trends like Java and Kotlin. I would suggest that we don't take either of the rankings for granted, but rather use them as a complementary to each other if we are to picture a more accurate image of the most popular languages out there. Coming to what should I choose? Whether Java or a Kotlin? Now, everyone has a confusion as to whether to go with Java or Kotlin. Here is the answer. Kotlin's documentation is very well implemented. If you look at the advantages of Kotlin app development, it is much better than Java on topics such as security, syntax, compatibility, and functional programming, and many more. Therefore, we can say that Kotlin is better than Java. But we should not agree with this. Will Kotlin replace Java is a question in everyone's mind. Now, we will see what is the solution for that. Why Kotlin will replace Java for Android app development? Although Java is starting to add some functional programming elements, but at its core Java, it is a procedural language still. There are many programming languages that you might have considered that are designed to run on the Java virtual machine. Although there are many languages that can compile Java bytecode, but there are few specialties of Kotlin that make it a way better than the others in terms of null safety, which I mentioned before. Everyone has a doubt that should we learn Java before Kotlin? However, there is no need to master Java before you begin learning Kotlin. But currently being able to convert between the two is still a requirement for effective development. Kotlin simply makes your life easier as a Java developer. Now, you tell me, according to you guys, which one is better, Java or a Kotlin? So guys, this brings us to the end of this session. Now, I have a question for you. Which code basically defines Kotlin EO, whether the first one or a second one?
So guys, I hope you found this video informative. Do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you get notifications of our next videos. And if you have any queries, do leave a comment and we'll get back to you. Thank you for watching.